Hello everyone, my name is Ali Abdul Karim Samu and I'm your host for the IBL Literary Society ka podcast. And I'm here with my friend, dear Asad Alvi, author, poet, writer, translator, everything really, pretty much. They've translated, they've written for publications like Dawn, Scroll, all around the world, and are here to have a chit-chat with me. So, what happened was, we basically did a whole recording, but that was too formal, so we're going to make it informal this time.
Yes, absolutely. So,
and like, make it more about how we're feeling and how the kind of literary and theoretical concepts that we're dealing with these days in our
lives.
Yeah, right?
Like we started with...
Colonialism,
where then
we're just too structured of a thing, right?
Yeah, like, and then I started explaining like the history of colonialism, which I don't even like properly know. And then I'm like, yeah, we don't need to have this informal, like, this formal conversation because ye concepts, ye hamare ird gird hain, ye phele mein, right? So, mujhe raat ko aajkal neend nahi aati. That's like a problem. I can probably trace back to corporate culture and colonialism and modernity or whatever.
No,
right?
That's right. I mean, because so like.
So I think ehsaasat ke baare mein hame baat karni
chahiye.
Emotions ke baare mein. Yeah.
So like. See, the thing was, I mean, that's not something I was talking to you about it earlier this morning. Right?
Yeah.
That this is something that I've been feeling lately.
Mm.
In the wake of this ecological crisis that we're in, right?
You mean this city?
This city.
This world.
This world.
Yeah.
This post-industrialist world.
Yeah, yeah.
But like, I mean, ecology as a critique of modernity, right? And
it's very funny, actually, that sorry to cut you.
No,
I'm quite
ahead.
Famous at cutting people. Not
okay.
Their throats, like their words.
Achha.
But it's nice that you say, like, ecological crisis, because abhi we're looking out through a window.
Yeah.
And we're on the 14th floor? No. Sorry, the fourth floor, but you know, it's like heightened, so mujhe lag raha it's the 14th floor of the Aman CD Tower inside the IBA and the city campus, and we're looking at the city and we can see the skyline, and it's a really kind of smelly, dusty window. And you can actually only see the city as this really gray mass, you know, this gray vapor, really, of pollution, of smoke, of smog. So it's very interesting.
And of concrete.
All we see is blocks of concrete.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm thinking of Fez when he says, you know, har baam par gard, on every roof there is dust. Something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, but when you said ecological crisis, it's so interesting because we have this massive window behind us and we're literally witnessing crisis.
Ecological crisis.
Right now.
That's true, because, see...
But
like,
go on, continue your thoughts.
Like, I don't know, like, so this past week, we've been sort of involved with conversations, right? Saad, my ex-roommate, to introduce him, the president of this society, the one who initiated this. Anyway, so Saad and I went to these workshops, right? And we sort of got in touch with these conversations about...
Ecological workshops.
Somewhat, you could say. I mean, it was something about... it was something about the ecology and, you know, convivialism. Okay. But anyway... but the ecological aspect of the conversation sort of related to how us, and even today in Dr. Nosheen's class, my anthropology class, even she mentioned the same thing, that the planet was never meant for concrete, right? Like, it's our, so what the word she used was gurur. Right?
Gurur.
Gurur, yeah. It's the insani gurur.
Ignorance.
Ignorance, yeah. That's led us to thinking that we are able to dominate ecology. That we are superior and all the other species, everything else that lives around us, including animals, plants, everything, right? Everything's inferior and we can assert our dominance over them. And that's something that has been really confusing me, because I look at Karachi and I so desperately wanted to be green. And I so like desperately wanted to be like, because I personally love Karachi. I'm sorry. You all know I romanticize the heck out of Karachi.
And you're also desperate.
I'm also desperate.
In general, as a person. No, I love you. No.
But like...
Yeah.
Karachi, right? Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
I want this beautiful city, this diverse city...
Right.
...to be more eco-friendly.
Right.
More... Like, I know, like, this, you know, podcast might not be about eco-friendly... things, but I mean, we have a whole society dedicated to that.
No,
but
you see,
like,
also,
that's
these
a concern, right?
Issues are all connected, right? So even if we formally decided that this podcast is going to be about modernity or capitalism, all these buzzwords, it's very telling that we planned to have this conversation about that, but we immediately thought of ecology.
Yeah.
Because all of these issues are connected, you know? Kuch bhi mukhtalif nahi hai. Sab kuch
jura
hai. Again, to quote Fez again, I don't know, I just love Fez these days. I'm writing a piece on him. It's very nice. He says ke zindagi kya kisi muflis ki qaba hai? Is life the... Is it the garment worn by the downtrodden? So think, if we think of life, our lived experiences, as a massive garment... तो हर कपड़े के बहुत सारे धागे होते हैं उनको साथ सिया जाता है तो कपड़ा बनता है सो नन ऑफ दीस थिंग्स आर कनेक्टेड मतलब अगर तुम्हारी जिंदगी एक फटी हुई कबा है अली जो के है एक्चुअली तो सवाल ये है कि ये इन तमाम धागों के नाम क्या हैं एक धागे का नाम इकोलॉजी होगा एक धागे का नाम
मॉडर्निटी
होगा और ये तमाम चीजें जुड़ के एक ये कबा या ये कपड़ा सिलवाया जाता है और लोग इसको पहनते हैं चंद लोग इसको पहन के खुश होते हैं चंद लोग इसको पहन के खुश नहीं होते चंद लोग चाहते हैं बरा ना घूमे तो सॉरी दिस इज टू पोएटिक बट यू नो आई लव द वर्ड बरहना इट मींस टू बिकम वल्नरेबल इट एक्चुअली मींस न्यूड आई मीन ऑन अ लिटरल वे बट अ फाइनर ट्रांसलेशन इज एक्चुअली वल्नरेबल एंड इफ यू थिंक ऑफ जूडिथ बटलर एंड द आइडिया ऑफ vulnerability as one of the affects or emotions that is so central to any political organization, you know, then actually this entire idea of barhana works. And I'm only citing, I mean, this because in this space also we're being vulnerable and the podcast is about vulnerability. But yes, let's bring our rhizomatic sort of spread back to a point. Yes, so we were speaking of ecology. I mean, and we'll move on. As we move on, you know, in this podcast, we'll speak about larger issues that are affecting us as citizens of the city.
But also, like, so yesterday we went to Umar Wasim's work. We saw...
At the Biennale,
yeah. We saw, like, again... That is also about ecology, right? I just want to sort of involve myself with the space that ecology creates, right? Because Umar's work is about space and about ecology.
It's about how concrete also engages with plant life.
So there is a conversation. There's a negotiation almost. Umar Wasim, if you all don't know, is an amazing person and artist.
And
here in Karachi. And teaches at Indus Valley and is a great friend.
I'm thinking about their work actually a lot these days in relation to the city. So, to bring us back to, I mean, the earlier point that you were making about Professor Nosheen's course. And you said that she said that it's a relationship of ignorance that we have to the city. Or to things around us, right? And you use the word ghurur, maghroor ho jana. It's very interesting because this is actually quite Sufi.
Yeah.
The idea of becoming maghroor, or I mean, the Sufis formally use the word ghafil, ghafil ho jana. You know, so dam ghafil, so hum kafir. غافل ہو جانا اینڈ دا آئیڈیا آف غفلت فرگیٹ فلنس یو نو دا صوفیز بلیو دیٹ وین وی بیکم غافل اور وین وی بیکم اگنورنٹ دین کی ریلیشن شپس دیٹ وی شوڈ بی مینٹیننگ ٹوورڈ لینڈ ٹوورڈز ادر پیپل اراؤنڈ اس ٹوورڈز اور سیلفس دیز ریلیشن شپس بیکم ڈسٹرائڈ ان دا مومنٹ آف غفلت سو دا اسٹرگل ریئلی از ٹو maintain those relationships alive and to not let the heart become ghafil. Mm-hmm. I am only mentioning Sufism is because we are speaking of ecology and there's a long history of in certainly within Sindh. I don't want to use interior Sindh. I hate when people go like, same. There is an interior Sindh and there is an exterior Sindh. Hum abhi exterior mein baithe hain. I mean, you know, this is a very colonial way of speaking.
I got this invitation pamphlet thing.
Yeah.
Which said, Karachi. the itinerary sort of said, departure Karachi 10 a.m. Sindh.
To Sindh. Like Karachi like, is not in Sindh.
Oh my. That's a whole in the political conversation. That's a whole debate. Yeah. Let's get back to
But so I'm only saying this because within, Sindh, there has been a long history archive of indigenous movements around land that invoke Sufi concepts and metaphors. And the prime example is, of course, the saint who haunts my dreams, who is Shah Hussain, Shah Inayat of Jhok. And for those of my friends who are listening, they know that I am obsessed with Shah Inayat. But
for those of you who don't know, kindly explain who Shah Inayat is.
We'll come back to Shah Inayat.
Okay.
Because I think we might digress a lot. Okay. And, you know. But it's very interesting that you use the word ignorance. I just wanted to say that. Because I think یہ ہے یہ غفلت کا عمل یا اگنورنس کا عمل یا غرور مغرور ہو جانے کا عمل آئی تھنک یہی ہمارا جو رشتہ ہے اپنے آپ کے ساتھ اپنی اپنی ذات کے ساتھ شہر کے ساتھ اس کو خراب کرتا ہے اور ہمیں بہت ضرورت ہے کہ ہم اس غرور کو اور غرور از واٹ ایکچولی آئی مین ہم کہتے ہیں نا تم بہت غرور ہو تمہیں بڑا غرور ہے بڑے مغرور ہو تم اٹس پرائڈ It's pride, right? It's the capacity to say, I, you know? So it's an extremely narcissistic gesture where people only think about themselves. They only act upon objects. You know, to say, main kahun ke maine kursi, maine table par kitab rakhi. To main maujood hai is jumle mein. اور ٹیبل موجود ہے جو کہ آبجیکٹ ہے اور میں اس پہ ایکٹ اپون کر رہا ہوں آئی ایم کیپنگ دا بک آن دا ٹیبل رائٹ سو وی ہیو دس سبجیکٹ آبجیکٹ ریلیشن شپ ویئر آئی ایم لائک دا آئی سوورن سبجیکٹ وچ از ریئلی غرور اٹس دا آئیڈیا کہ اٹس دا آئیڈیا آف پرائڈ دا سوورن سبجیکٹ اور میں چیزوں پہ ایکٹ کرتا ہوں میں یہ اجازت نہیں دیتا کہ چیزیں مجھ پہ ایکٹ کریں میری ذات کو انفلوئنس کریں تو ہم ہمیشہ لینڈ پہ ایکٹ کرتے ہیں ہم لینڈ کو پکڑتے ہیں سیز کرتے ہیں کالونائز کرتے ہیں لیکن ہم نے یہ سوچنا ہی چھوڑ دیا ہے کہ کوئی ایسی پاسبلٹی بھی موجود ہو کہ لینڈ ہماری ذات کو انفلوئنس کرے میں چاہتا ہوں درخت مجھ سے بات کریں درخت مجھ سے اپنی زبان میں بات کریں اور درختوں کی زبان ہوتی ہے
ہمیں سنائی نہیں دیتی. It has a whole Vedic history.
Absolutely. There are languages, they are uncoded. These things speak. But it's interesting, to, just to sort of bring us back to ignorance, it's interesting that Professor Anwar, and you know, you use the word ignorance, I simply wanted to connect that to Sufism and you know, how Sufi metaphors are evoked for urban activism in the city and also within our history. But that's also because mere andar keeda hai, I will bring everything back to Sufism. You know, ghuma phira ke. But it's interesting. I think if we think of this podcast as a long conversation about modernity, then we've covered one segment of the podcast, which is ecology. But the larger conversation is to connect these issues like ecology, the city, to a bala called modernity. which is what the podcast is formally
about.
So I will let you begin. Although we've begun.
Okay, but like, but yeah, I mean, yeah, sure. Like, explain, elaborate.
Explain what?
Elaborate what you are trying to like. Elaborate modernity. Elaborate.
The term.
Yeah.
The definition.
Yeah. And in the context of our experiences, I think our specifically the Pakistani lived experience.
Right.
Like theoretically and practically.
Right. I mean, it's a very interesting word. ठीक है ना? It's a purana word. It's a जिसे कहते हैं उर्दू में कि खरा लफ्ज या यू नो बिल्कुल बैठा हुआ जचा हुआ इट्स वेरी पॉपुलर एंड इट्स वेरी वाइडली यूज्ड अक्सर बहुत लोगों को पता नहीं होता मुझे भी नहीं पता था चंद साल पहले कि इस लफ्ज का मतलब क्या है so that it's an important question to ask what do we really mean by something called modernity. A lot of people say main bahut modern hu ya aap bahut modern hai, you know, and when a lot of times I'm learning with someone, teaching in a workshop, anything, a lot of people will be like, oh, this, well, you're talking about modernity, to modern hona to achhi baat hai और हम मॉडर्न बिल्कुल हैं और हम नहीं हैं ट्रेडिशनल रिवायती तो एक ये पॉपुलर तो नहीं आई मीन यू नो वी आल्सो लाइक आई हेट व्हेन पीपल जस्ट गो लाइक ओ तुम तो बड़े पॉपुलर चीज़ें देखते हो एंड आई डू द एकेडमिक थिंग्स सो आई मीन आई डोंट वांट टू यूज द वर्ड पॉपुलर बट नॉर्मेटिव लेट्स जस्ट यूज दैट वर्ड इंस्टेड बिकॉज आई मीन आई लव पॉपुलर विजुअल कल्चर पॉपुलर लिटरेरी कल्चर आई मीन ऑल सूफी कल्चर्स आर रियली पॉपुलर कल्चर सो आई डोंट हैव एनीथिंग अगेंस्ट द टर्म ठीक है ना
ओके
दिस इज ऑन रेकॉर्ड सो लेट्स जस्ट यूज द वर्ड नॉर्मेटिव
या
और अज्यूम्ड यू नो सो देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आई एम यूजिंग इट अगेन पॉपुलर बट नॉर्मेटिवली पीपल When people say modern, they think of it in a binary, you know? Jaise kaale ke baraks safed hota hai, thande ke baraks garam hota hai, waise hi modernity ya modern, ya jisko hum jadid kehte hain Urdu mein, uske baraks hoti hai rivayat. या आपकी हाँ रिवायत ही कह सकते हैं ट्रेडिशन सो देर इज दिस बाइनरी ऑफ ट्रेडिशन एंड मॉडर्निटी राइट दैट अ लॉट ऑफ सो व्हेन पीपल से मैं बहुत मॉडर्न हूँ इट सीम्स लाइक दे वांट टू डिसोसिएट देमसेल्व्स फ्रॉम समथिंग दैट दे थिंक इज
नॉट मॉडर्न
और ट्रेडिशनल राइट सो दिस इज लाइक द वर्किंग काइंड ऑफ डेफिनेशन दैट वी हैव इन यू नो इन सॉर्ट ऑफ पोस्ट कलोनियल स्टडीज़ और कलोनियल स्टडीज़ तो मैं उसको बड़ा एक आराम से बिखरे हुए अंदाज में मैं उसको समझाना चाह रहा हूँ एंड देन अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल से दैट देन सो एक तो ये बाइनरी बन गया फिर हमेशा ऐसे बाइनरीज में ये होता है कि ठंडी चीज़ बुरी है और गर्म चीज़ बेहतर है बेटा गर्म कपड़े पहनो ठंडे कपड़े ना पहनो व्हाटएवर व्हाट आर इवन बाय द वे ठंडा कपड़ास देयर आर नो कपड़ास और देयर आर गरम कपड़ास और पीपल से के यू नो गोरा बेहतर है और वो बेहतर नहीं है बाकी जो नस्लें हैं वो बेहतर नहीं है सिमिलरली ट्रेडिशन एंड मॉडर्निटी का जो ये बाइनरी है बाइनरी को पता नहीं उर्दू में क्या कहते हैं लेकिन दो जज्बियत कह सकते हैं दो जज्बियत डुअलिज्म या फिर हाँ दो जज्बियत इज एक्चुअली अ वेरी गुड ट्रांसलेशन इट्स एक्चुअली नॉट माइन इट्स फ्रॉम अ उर्दू क्रिटिक नासिर नय्यर हु हैज़ अ बुक कॉल्ड उर्दू इट्स कॉल्ड द मॉडर्न उर्दू प्रोज एंड द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ मॉडर्न उर्दू प्रोज एंड ही काइंड ऑफ थियराइज़ he kind of like traces like the colonial underpinnings of how modern Urdu prose came into being. Wo do jazbiyat often use karte hain to name dualism. Anyways, ek ye do raaye hain ke ek taraf aapki riwayat hai aur ek taraf aapki jadid hai. Ab isme hota ye hai ke aapne pehle binary bana diya, ab ek behtar hoga ek bura hoga. To jadid acha hai aur riwayat buri hai. Acha ye bhi hame nahi maloom ke jadid hai kya aur riwayati kya hai. To pehle to phir hame wo list banani padegi ke ye tamam cheeze riwayati hain, agarche wo riwayati nahi hain.
But फिर उसमें subjectivity आ जाती है.
जैसे मेरे लिए चलना is not necessarily tradition.
Yeah.
लेकिन लोग कहेंगे आप गाड़ी में नहीं जाते, आप बड़े रिवायती, आपका एक, मेरे लिए नहीं है, मैं तो चल रहा हूँ.
Yeah, वही ना. Yeah.
So it's when I'm saying के tradition and modernity, I want us to be very careful that these are constructs. These are we are naming things. They are not necessarily in and of themselves traditional or modern. We imbue them with an association. And we say, ek behtar hai aur dusri behtar nahi hai. We kind of like labeling, right? So, hum fehrist bana sakte hain. Jaise ke badi imaratein jadid hain, modern hain, behtar hain. Chote ghar ya communes bure hain. Ya ऐसी कम्युनिटीज जिनकी दीवारें नहीं हैं, गेटेड नहीं हैं, वो बुरी हैं क्योंकि वहाँ पे वायलेंस हो सकता है. यू नो, इस तरह का एक एग्जांपल लोग देते हैं. तो आप जो है ना एक सेफ एरिया में जाएं, बड़ी बड़ी बिल्डिंग्स में, यू नो, वो बेहतर है आपके लिए. या गाड़ी में सफ़र करें और व्हाटएवर. सो देयर आर सर्टेन मोड्स दैट बिकम प्रिविलेज्ड, राइट, एंड देयर आर सर्टेन रिलेशनशिप्स दैट आर othered or are not thought of as legitimate. So it's often a discourse on legitimacy. What relationships have been named modern and are legitimate, and what have been named traditional and are therefore illegitimate. Right? I'll give you a couple of examples to make this more concrete. So mere nazdeek tumhare jo jawab ka sawal ka jawab tha, mere nazdeek modernity hai. That it's basically a historical period. It's a name really. That it's an association that we give to a certain period, and we give it a very positivistic value. So we say ye ek khas तारीख में एक मखसूस एक हिस्सा था जो जहाँ पे हमें जदीदियत मिली, और वो बस वो बेहतर है, हिस्ट्री का उरूज है, और उससे पहले या उसके बाद जितनी भी चीज़ें हैं वो बेकार हैं. राइट, सो दैट्स द वे आई अंडरस्टैंड इट, राइट, एंड दैट्स द वे दैट पीपल काइंड ऑफ लाइक नॉर्मेटिवली शहर में हर जगह इस तरीके से ही देखते हैं कि ये यू नो जदीद गाना, जदीद चीज़. बट अगर हम इसको थोड़ा एकेडमिकली भी देखें, सोशल साइंसेस में जाएं या लिबरल आर्ट्स में जाएं, डिसिप्लिन मतलब हमारी डिग्री जो है, सो आईबीए की भी, वहाँ पे जैसे हमें पढ़ाया जाता है, it begins समवेयर. इट बिगिंस विद फॉर इंस्टेंस द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन. एक रेवोल्यूशन आया, लोगों ने मशीन ईजाद की. लोगों को लगा कि अब तो हमारा काम बड़ा जल्दी भी हो रहा है.
But I think it, there's also this whole debate about the 1500s, right? So there's a whole discourse on the arrival of the Renaissance.
Right.
And the arrival of reason.
Right.
The whole Weberian concept of sort of development stages, right? The developmental stage of reason is also what people associate with modernity, right?
Right.
Like theoretically, sort of mentally, in a lived experience,
right?
Right. So and it's completely associated with the Industrial Revolution as well. Okay, people think there's more accessibility now, there's lesser restrictions, there's more economic capital ka flow, there's more to everything, and there's more globality involved, right? There's more accessibility.
Right. I mean,
and I think that's what it perhaps initially became.
Right.
That, again, of course, in a positivist way.
Right.
In a very, very rationalistic, reasonistic way.
Right.
And then proceeded to become what it became.
You're right. But yes, I mean I don't really like the word inception or origin or roots, but it can be traced back to a certain history, which we can locate in Western Christian humanism, the Renaissance. Mm-hmm. But the reason why I specifically don't want to go in that direction, is because we're not in an academic setting.
Yeah.
So I don't want everybody to feel ki hum ye ab kya baatein kar rahe hain, humanism kya bala hai aur ye reason kya hota hai. Reason ko akal kehte hain. What I want to do is translate these concepts with respect to hamare jo rozmarra ke issues hain, right? Because it's actually, I mean, you can formally study this. It's true, I did. And I can do that for you. I lay that out, that kind of history. But we shouldn't do that, I think, because I think we should also understand that there is a certain kind of contemporaneity to concepts. Every concept actually is contemporary, right? So contemporary se murad abhi ho raha hai, yahan ho raha hai. तो आपको माजी को पढ़ना बहुत ज़रूरी है मेरे लिहाज से लेकिन मेरी अपनी चूँकि जो ट्रेनिंग है वो हिस्ट्री में नहीं है मेरी अपनी ट्रेनिंग लिटरेरी स्टडीज़ में है अदब में तो नज़म मेरे सामने मौजूद होती है और मैं उसको पढ़ता हूँ तो व्हेन आई से दैट देयर इज़ अ कंटेम्पोरेनिटी टू कॉन्सेप्ट्स व्हाट आई मीन इज़ दैट जो भी चीज़ें हम ट्रेस कर सकते हैं उन जीनियोल उन तमाम तर तारीखों में अगरचे हम चाहे वहाँ चले जाएं ह्यूमनिज्म की तरफ चले जाएं या हम इनलाइटनमेंट की तरफ चले जाएं यू नो एंड वी क्रिटिकली फॉर इंस्टेंस अनपैक व्हाट इज़ इट दैट व्हाट इज़ सो पिक्यूलियर अबाउट द इनलाइटनमेंट फिलोसफर्स राइट and how is it that they actually make a certain kind of very pernicious power possible? You know, if you read them very carefully, they are violent texts. But the reason I don't want to go there is because I also acknowledge ke ye tamam jo ideas hain, ye violences jo hain, inki leaks, aap leak keh lein. Jaise meri nani thi, to wo kehte unke ghar mein jo hai na ek chhat pe leak thi. वो उनके मरने तक ठीक नहीं हुई तो वो लीक होती रही होती रही होती रही तो वो एक दिन मेरी अम्मा से कहा कि जो है ना कि फेरोज़ा मैंने तुम्हारे शौहर को कितनी दफ़ा कहा है कि लीक को सही करे इसकी मरम्मत करे लेकिन ये अभी तक ये लीक हो रही है तो ये उसकी ना पितृशाही की ये वाहिद निशानदेही है कि ये लीक ही हो रही है सो यू नो आई वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड कॉन्सेप्ट those that leak into the present moment. Main yahan is dariche se bahar dekh raha hun. You know, we've established in the beginning ke hum fourth floor pe hain and we're looking at the city. Every single thing that the Enlightenment philosophers are saying or this privileging of reason within the Enlightenment or within specific appropriations of Aristotle, of Plato, of classical Western texts under the Enlightenment. I mean, Aristotle also, for instance, comes, you know, into the Islamic world through Ibn Rushd, through Averroes. But Thomas Aquinas, at the same time, is trying to Christianize Aristotle. And then that Christianized Aristotle, which is a very selective appropriation of Aristotle, leaks into the Enlightenment. Right? Where a certain kind of reason in Aristotle is obsessed over and privileged by these philosophers. Whereas if you read Ibn Rushd, or even if you read the Sufi writer Sohrawardi, who is citing Aristotle, reason is not as such privileged. He engages with other aspects of Aristotle also. So, iski tarikh mein hum ja sakte hain. Kisne kaun sa text uthaya, kaun se philosopher ne kya uski gat banayi, phir wo reason privilege hua, phir wo yahan pe aaya. But wo hum sab ek academic situation mein karte hain, you know, introductory level courses mein, colonial studies, post-colonial studies. Aur phir ye to aapki ho gayi jo yahan pe hua, South Asia mein. Phir settler colonialism alag. Uski ek alag aapko phir genealogy samajhni padegi. You'll have to understand relationships that native, we should not really use Native Americans.
The First Nations.
We should say the First Nations. Sovereign nations. Because they were sovereign. Un relations ko samajhna padega. To iski tarikh mein, मैं जा सकता हूँ, मैं बता सकता हूँ कि किस तरीके से, कहाँ से, कौन से टेक्स्ट में से रीज़न को उठाया गया, कहाँ पे प्रिविलेज किया गया, लेकिन फ़र्क, लेकिन बात तो यही है ना कि अगर मैं अभी मैं किसी को बोलूँ कि यार मुझे बहरिया टाउन में नहीं रहना, मुझे रहना है, मैं जाके भिक्षा में रहूँगा शाइन के अंदर, तो पहली चीज़ जो मेरी मिडिल क्लास अब्बा मुझे बोलेंगे, वो बोलेंगे कि ये क्या बेवकूफ़ों वाली बातें, तुम्हारी अक्ल कहाँ गई, तो रीजन तो आ गया ना. सो आई विल सो इट्स लाइक डेकार्ट और दीज एनलाइटनमेंट फिलोसफर्स हॉन्टिंग माई फादर, वेदर माई फादर इज अवेयर ऑफ दिस और नॉट. ये भूत हैं, ये इतनी जल्दी नहीं जाएंगे, राइट. सो व्हेन वी से मॉडर्निटी, दैट्स व्हाट वी मीन, राइट. We mean certain relationships that become privileged. These are always rational. Akal wali cheeze ho, behtar ho. Speed again becomes privileged, right? I was just speaking about the isi jo baat hui, industrial revolution, right? Ki ek tarikh mein ek hissa aaya, machine invent hui. Pehle log ek alag tarike se kaam karte the, ab machine aayi, logon ne ek alag tarike se kaam karna shuru kiya, logon ko laga कि तेज़ काम करना शायद बेहतर है और शायद आहिस्ता काम करना बुरी बात है या बेहतर नहीं है, राइट. सो इससे ये हुआ कि थिंग्स लाइक स्पीड, लाइक रीजन, लाइक, एंड वी कैन मेक अ लिस्ट, बिकेम नेम्ड एज मॉडर्न और बिकेम एसोसिएटेड विद मॉडर्न मॉडर्निटी, कि ये मॉडर्न जिंदगी है. You know, हम इश्तेहार देखते हैं ना बहरिया टाउन के हर जगह के,
तेज
जिंदगी, मॉडर्न जिंदगी, एंड एवरीथिंग दैट इज, दैट डज नॉट सर्व दोज पर्पसेस. इफ आई एम नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन स्पीड, आई एम नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन फॉर एवर रिमेनिंग कनेक्टेड टू यू थ्रू द इंटरनेट, आई एम नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन मूविंग इन टू दिस इलीट नेबरहुड और व्हाटएवर, तो फिर मुझे कहा जाएगा ये पागल है, ये बेवकूफ है, ये इसको अकल नहीं
है. Oftentimes ये बागी है.
ये बागी है. So that the figure of the, the figure of the mad person, and here we can go into Foucault, right? The history of madness, right? ये बागी है, the rebel. या फिर ये उल्लू है, the animal really, animal गधा है. Animal metaphors are also true, right? Because animality ke bhi baare mein hum baat kar sakte hain. To round this sort of up, this is why I think we should also often try to locate ourselves a little in literary studies. Because, you know, now when I enter literary studies, then I can like theorize. I can be like, I am going to look at the figure of the ullu or the figure of the mad person or the figure of this. These are, and then the contemporaneity of these concepts stays alive. क्योंकि मेरा बाप तो मुझे कहेगा ये तो उल्लू है, लेकिन कांट वहां पे बैठा हुआ है या डेकार्ट बैठा हुआ है, वो थोड़ी मुझे देख के, या हेगल, वो थोड़ी मुझे देख के कह रहे हैं कि ये उल्लू है, कोई असद अलवी 2019.
आई थिंक इट ऑल कम्स बैक टू एन इकोलॉजिकल असिमिलेशन एज वेल, राइट, लाइक सॉर्ट ऑफ एसोसिएटिंग योरसेल्फ विद दीस लिटरेरी स्टडीज,
या
यू सॉर्ट ऑफ बिकम देम,
एग्जैक्टली,
एंड दैट्स द you know, amazing thing about...
Because it's relationships, right? It's our around. Hai. Yeah. So I'm not necessarily saying that we should not engage with history. I absolutely think we should study those texts, critically inhabit them, and deconstruct them from within, which is to say, destabilize their assumptions from within. At the same time, we should focus on the literary, everyday, ephemeral aspects jo hame shehar mein hamare ird gird nazar aate hain, and we should pay attention to them and cling to them.
That is amazing. Thank you so much, Asad Alvi. We'll round this up here. Thank you so much for being us, for all of those who have stuck around. Perhaps we'll talk about post-modernity.
I think humne bahut rant kiya hai.
But that's nice. I mean, that's nice. So, yeah, amazing. Thank you so much for listening. Allah Hafiz.